I picked up this credenza on the Facebook Marketplace for $50. It was pretty banged up, a lot of knocks, a lot of dings to it, but I thought with a really good cleaning, I could maybe do something with it, if not maybe practice some art onto this. I'm gonna apply some wood filler to change the hardware on this, but first what I'll do is I will fill up the holes, and I'd like to apply a little tape into the back so that way I'm making sure I've got all the wood filler from the front to the back of the drawer. Then I'll go ahead and screw in for a new hardware piece. I'm just gonna use some chalk paint. It's nice and thick, and this way I'm gonna get really good coverage. So I'm gonna apply two full coats onto this piece before I do anything. I wanna also create a lot of texture, so I'm just gonna brush the paint on almost every which way. With chalk paints, they dry in an ultra matte finish, so there's no sheen to it, which is perfect to make this a canvas piece. Always wait for each coat to dry 100%. And then you're good to go. So I'm just gonna draw out what I thought might be kind of a cool idea. And I actually really wanna show you the simplicity of actually creating your own artwork onto pieces of furniture. And I wanna share a technique I haven't done in a while. So all I'm doing is drawing out some sailboats, and then I'm gonna do a black outline. And it's gonna be a little bit jumbled around, nothing's gonna be permanent, because it's all about kind of outlining how you want to see it. So I'm gonna try some yellows, a few blues, but the biggest thing is they're quite easy to draw, so you don't have to feel like you're any type of artist by any means, and have some fun with it. I love to use the palette knife, and you can use a plastic one, a metal one, or you could even use a fork. But I love the effect, and generally when I'm using it, I like to play around with where you can kind of throw the paint a little bit. So what I'm doing is I'm just taking some jet black paint, and I'm just kind of adding in some lines, and I'll go vertical and horizontal with it. But you can get really nice precision lines with it, but I love the look of it. But if you're somebody that hasn't really painted a lot, this is actually a really great way to practice. And you can pick all kinds of kind of art effects. You could draw some buildings. I like to use the sailboats onto this piece because I was kind of going with a little bit of a nautical theme. And I'm also playing around with my shades. So I'm just using a small artist brush and I'm just kind of putting in a little bit of water, a little bit of skyline, and I'm constantly making mistakes, but I'm also constantly just going back and rerouting myself. But it's all part of the process and it can be a lot of fun. Anytime that I do paint, it is really just about layers. So the first couple of layers look a little bit not very well conditioned or blended, but that's okay. What you're doing is you're building up texture and you're also building up depth and dimension. And the two biggest shades I'm always going to be using is black and white, and that's really going to make things kind of give it a pop. But I would really love to show you how to do a cityscape because it's really just how to create that illusion that it's down a street. And you can do an entire painting just with a palette knife. And you have to kind of just play around and see what happens. I'll brush up and I'll brush down and I'll even go side to side with a palette knife. And I love that kind of organic effect it will give. And again, I'm just trying to create depth around the boats as well as into the water a little bit. So I'm also going to be using white with a palette knife. So I'm using kind of this contrast of the black and the white. And anytime I didn't like what I ended up doing, I would just go back to my base color, not a problem at all. And I really had fun just playing around, as it's been a really long time since I've played with this type of art or type of tools with this kind of art. I love abstract and I also like figurative art. So it's about making an image appear to be something, but it's about the abstract of just kind of connecting it the way you see it. But I just kept going and then I kind of wanted to stop and I thought what I would do is give the kind of the whole piece a little bit more mood. So what I decided to do is go ahead and give it a cream color chalk paint wash, And I'm gonna use a moist towel, and I'm just gonna go around and I'm going to dab at the wash itself. And this is gonna actually create a really fun texture on top. So I'd like to move that rag around as much as possible, and I kind of overlap the wash so that way you're not gonna see any lines. So I'll go around to all the corners and the crevices and drawers, as well as the entire front piece. And what I really want to do is be able to give the entire picture of the sailboats and of this kind of mood. It's kind of moody, kind of giving it kind of a storm-like effect that's going on around the boats, but I didn't want it to be too gray. You want to make sure everything is completely dry for a good couple of hours before you go ahead and do your wash. But I really was happy with how the extra texture from this kind of a rag wash technique gave the entire piece, including what I had painted. So what I decided to do, just to give it another little bit of more pop to it, is go around with the palette knife and just add a little bit more of the black and white, just to kind of bring it back to give it more dimension again. Something I wanted to try for a little while is actually making some sailboats, just to kind of go with the nautical theme again. I've seen tons of pictures online, so I thought I would just use some old scrap material that I have. I'm using some scissors just for the material, and then I found some old pieces of driftwood just across the street in the park. So I'm gonna cut basically the sails themselves, and I tried to measure out from the dowel that I'm going to be using. So I just picked up some dowels. You can get those at the dollar store. And you can use any kind of string that you want. I found these little tiny hook screws. So this will be part of anchoring my sails. And I also anchored it into the dowels, and I'll show you what I did with that. I really love that organic look that these little sailboats have. So I thought by giving it a try and see what I could make with what I already had at home. I'm sure there's a few different types of ideas and supplies that you could use, but I found that this was pretty easy. So I used the same drill that I did for the dresser just to make a hole for the dowel. If your wood piece is soft enough, you could probably even just use a really fat screw and then knock it in with a hammer. So I used those little tiny screw pegs and I put them on either side of the wood, and then I also added in the dowel into the center. I just used a screw to make tiny little holes into the fabric, and then I'm gonna add the string into the fabric. So there's 3 points to each sail. I think next time I would actually make seams around my sails, and I would use a much softer thread in order to hang the sail. But overall, it turned out pretty good. I liked the sailboats I did, but I really wasn't that happy. So I decided to go ahead and paint the whole front again, and I'm gonna actually repaint it. And again, I kinda wanted to go with a happy, kind of a beach theme. So again, this is just gonna end up being really good practice. Plus I wanted to share the knife and the using the knife palette for art. But there's so many things that you can draw out and that you can paint and have fun. And really, for a piece of furniture like this, which has absolutely no dimension, it's a box with drawers and some doors. So it's a really good canvas to play around. If you're not really into the art, you could also just use stencils as well. But it's the fun of playing with the shading, and this is a really good practice, especially for me. It always starts out with just kind of the basic of the frame of what I want to paint, but I'm constantly having to correct something and change it, and it's going around and kind of figuring out from the size and the dimension, from the legs to the back of the head, even my background. And then the other thing I try to focus on, but have fun while I'm doing it, is the shadowing. So from the background shadow to the actual focal point of the shadowing. I love using sponges when I'm painting. And the main reason is because this allows me to kind of not have to use rules, and it allows me to build some really amazing texture. And you really want to get bold with some of the colors you want to use. You can always grab a little bit of that black and a little bit of that white, and you can actually mute it and create even more depth. But the one thing I really love about figurative art is it's to look like it's something, but especially when you're up close and personal with it, it doesn't really look like that until you really stand back. So it's kind of this mix of abstract and figurative art. But again, it's playing with the shading, and you can have so much fun. You don't have to be conformed just with the black and white, but you could use darker tone colors and then use really light tone colors and still get an amazing effect. So if you wanted to paint, I don't know, fruits or flowers, anything that you're comfortable with, but shading is the big thing, and building your layers. Never be afraid to painting something. We all have to start somewhere, and it's actually a lot easier than you think. We're probably more scared of the outcome than we are of the actual process. That's why I encourage anybody to just really enjoy the process. Plus, it's a lot of fun to make your own colors. Making your own colors is a lot of fun, and you can also make your own tones by adding a little bit of white or a little bit of black, but even just putting a little bit of a gray tone into some of the really concentrated, highly pigmented colors will give you a whole new palette to work with. But again, the fun part about using the sponges when you're painting is it's really going to put that depth in. So when you want to grab a little bit more shadowing for your out background, kind of like what you're seeing me do now, it's perfect. And anywhere it's too concentrated, I can grab that sponge and just kind of dab in a whole bunch of white. But again, just like the sailboats, I am going ahead and I am using a lot of the white and the black to really add that depth and dimension. It is always really important to stand back as you're painting, because when you're sitting up close, especially with this type of abstract or figurative art, it starts to look a little muddled when you're looking at it up close. So it's really good to stand back, so this way you can kind of get better proportion. But sometimes that's the fun about working a little bit on the abstract side. But as you can see, I'm literally folding into the colors to kind of help with the colliding of one scene into another. And this also helps kind of buff out the imperfections. But this is all part of the figurative art, and it's so much fun, and it is super easy if you just grab a whole bunch of sponges, even cut them into smaller or use makeup sponges. But it's a great way to blend with your paints. And again, you can do this on furniture, you could do this on canvas art. One of the nicest things to really start, if you'd really like to try a little bit of painting, is to maybe do birds or fishes or fruits. And this will really allow you to play with those shades. And you can use that black and white to really help with that depth and that dimension. And again, having fun with the shading. It's all about using that sponge and just going over and over. And again, it was just a lot of fun to really practice on this piece. Now, I haven't decided if I like the sailboats better now or if I like this. Let me know in the comments below. I decided to go back and just kind of buff all the way around the actual painting portion that I've done, just adding a little bit of stippling with that base color of the chalk paint. So I will do a little bit more ragging with the cream, but I'm only going to go around the edges, and I'm really probably going to go with two or three layers of the ragging just to add that depth. And I'm going to go kind of into the painting, but this time I'm not going to go across the entire painting portion. But I have to admit, it was a lot of fun, and I'm always going back just to do little touch-ups. And I always say, or I at least speak for myself, I don't think I'm ever truly finished when I paint, but it is just knowing when to stop and enjoy what you've painted. And most of all, just learn from it and have fun with it. I promised myself one day I would practice again using oil paints, but I'm still not ready. I'll stick to acrylics and chalk paint. With oil, it's a completely different medium, and I'm so envious of those who can paint with oil. But I wanted to keep practicing, and again, showing you the basics of just drawing out something very primary. So here's just a little guy just kind of standing by, I don't know, kind of an ocean front or just a field, I hadn't decided. And I'm just gonna use the sole sponges again, making up my own aqua colors, adding in a little bit of gray as I go. And this is, again, just playing with the shading and the tone. So you wanna think very primary when you first start. And again, just having all those sponges that you can just keep layering on top of each other and have a lot of fun with it. Again, when I start anything, it's so primary. And then I go around and I figure out what kind of shading I want to do. And again, it doesn't matter what colors you want to use. You can use anything from a dark spectrum to the light spectrum. But again, I've been using a lot of the black and white to help me kind of go back and recorrect where the shading was either too dark or it wasn't conformed how I wanted it. I wanted to kind of give this particular painting kind of a cascade from the top of the board down as if the sun and the shadow was coming down. But I was making tons of mistakes with this one, and I think it was because I was starting to get a little bit tired. But that's okay. It's actually kind of fun to do things a little bit more freehand and also learn from your mistakes. So when I kind of jump into something thinking that this is going to work, it's so easy to go back and correct it. And that's the fun about using the sponges. And even the areas that I made mistakes, it still created more depth as I put more layers on. I think that was kind of the fun and what really kind of made me keep going. You honestly don't even really need a lot of fancy art tools to paint. That's why I really put a lot of emphasis on the sponging. And even the types of paints that you buy, you can buy a lot of stuff from the dollar store as well as even Walmart. But I really want to demonstrate in some upcoming videos how you can paint with even Q-tips and tinfoil, and you can really create some wild textures. One of my favorite things I ever painted, and this was quite a few years ago, was an orca coming out of the water, because you're really focusing on the black and the white. But it was the playing around and learning how to create that dimension of something actually in motion. And it was probably one of my most challenging pieces. And it really wasn't all about a lot of color, but I had so much fun. And an orca is an actual really easy thing to paint, but it's all the depth that you're creating. So again, getting up close and personal, you can see just the layers and layers from that primary stage. So I'm almost kind of pushing it out a little bit with the sponging and going back in. But underneath all of this is just a layer after a layer. And it goes very quickly with the sponging. If there's anything that you would like to learn more about in painting or types of painting or even objects of something to paint, please let me know in the comments below, because I love to teach people how to kind of come out of their shell or not fear to do things, because everybody's a beginner and everybody's an artist. I originally wasn't going to actually put this painting into this video because for some reason I was getting frustrated with it, and it's probably because I was so busy this week. But I am really glad that I actually did put it in, because it just goes to show that just because you're painting doesn't mean you have to be finished. So I probably will keep working on this even after this video, but if it does have a lot of changes to it, I'd be happy to share it with you. But again, it's all about practice, and it's been quite a few years since I've actually picked up a brush and a sponge and really played around. So I'd like to teach as much as I possibly can, so please, if you have something you'd like to learn, even from the basics of anything, please let me know. I would love to hear your comments. Thank you so much for watching this week's video, and I'm really looking forward to seeing you soon. Until then, take care.